Hey y'all, it's anime caveman. Today I'm going to be reviewing the 7th episode of Watashi, ni Tenshi, ga Maiorita. And this episode was actually pretty damn good, I gotta say. Because I like how in this episode you get to see some character development for Hana, Hinata, and you get to see some development for Miyako, because at least I like how in this episode you get to see Miyako actually grow as she becomes more responsible, because when the episode starts out with the best little sister in anime this season, when you see her little Hinata get sick, I like how in this episode you have Miyako grow up a bit by, instead of having the mom take a day out of work, Miyako actually takes a day out of university because it's not required attendance, and she takes care of her sister like a responsible adult. So I kind of like that. You see her go subtly into adulthood. And I like how even the mother later on in the episode actually praises her daughter too. And then when she says, just take it, I rarely have any opportunities to praise you. That was just a sweet scene right there to see that. So it did a good job into that standpoint for that reasons. And it also did a good job of giving off some character development for Hana. Because at the very least you see her slightly warming up to Miyako, and at the very least she is considerate of her slightly more, because I like how at the very least with Hana she actually kind of feels sorry for, kind of feels glad for her when she uses the card of Hinata not being close with Miyako for at least a week. That's what Miyako asks for. And I kind of like that sequence too, at the very least. And that little sequence where Hinata makes a wallet for Miyako, and then she makes little jokes saying that, but if you do this, you won't be able to use the I will do anything for you card. And then when Miyako was getting worried, and then Hana was saying she was joking, I like that. Because it shows at the very least that Hana's at least now feeling comfortable enough with Miyako to at least joke around a bit. And I kind of like sequences like that. It's subtle character development. And that's why I thought this episode also pumped in the standpoint of Hana's development too. And I also felt it did a good job with Hinata's character development. Because even though the intentions of Miyako were to have Hinata develop some independence, because Miyako wanted Hinata not to be so clingy, using the whole distance card for a week actually made Hinata love Miyako even more. So that was also another good sequence about this episode. And it was nice that even though Nao didn't have meant character development this episode, at least she was used as kind of like a comedic relief this episode in certain instances when she was dressing up as Miyako for like a few days, so that Hinata wouldn't feel so depressed about not being able to interact with her sister much. And then when she was being spoiled by Noah, those scenes were hilarious, especially when she was just giving her like fucking ice cream from an ice cream bucket. Those are sweet scenes. And then I like how this episode built up humor near the end when there was a countdown, and right when Hinata was able to be close with Miyako, she just did it instantly with like sparkling eyes, and you see Noah feel kind of sad because she liked being touched by, she loved it being touched by Hinata. So those sequences were kind of sweet too, I gotta say. So that's why I felt this episode was really good from the character standpoint for those reasons. And I thought it was good from the story department because it had a lot of great jokes. Like the sequences where you have Miyako tell Hana to pretty much not look at her while she's making cake, but then I like how it subverts our expectations, because you had actually this whole time Hana look at Miyako make the cake from behind, because Hana's not such a good cook. So that scene was pretty funny. I thought it was well timed and well placed due to the circumstances, because Miyako was making a cake for everyone. And I'd say really the only weak joke in this episode was when the stalker showed up out of nowhere. And that was probably like the only weak joke this whole entire episode. But that's about it. Every other joke was nice, and I loved it And then the scene where you have Noah and Hana try to comfort Hinata about Hinata not being able to be close with Miyako for a week. They try to like make this like talk to her to like calm her down the situation, and then it doesn't work until Miyako thinks the idea of giving Noah the tracksuit in a wig to make Noah look like Miyako. So that was also another good unique humor. So that's why I felt the story was nice in some instances. And then you have Miyako's mother actually show some sweetness for once towards Miyako. And I thought that was also another good thing from the story department. It makes Miyako's mother feel more balanced. And that's why I thought it did well from the story department. And then from the animation and art standpoint, I don't even have to talk about that. It was good as always. And then for sound, the voice acting was great. All the actresses did their job. And I freaking loved it. And that's why I'm going to give this episode an 8 out of 10. I thought it was pretty damn good. And that's why I love this episode. So anyways, guys and gals, these are my thoughts on the episode. Comment down your thoughts on the episode in the comments section. Rate the video whether you liked or disliked it. Share the video if y'all want to. And I'll see you guys later. Subscribe for more. Alright, thank you so much for watching, everyone. Have a great and safe day. Bye-bye.